struggling with her first serve of the game. She now ties the game with a tough one, 7 points apiece. To the power side. It's up. Ooh. Two hits, or a carry, rather, on Jasmine Fox as she tried to dig that one up. Off of the block. Now here's Charlotte Sider. Tough jump serve. Off the block and out. Back set. And a hit down the line. Breanne Hillhorse got a piece of it. Not enough. Here's Sarah Chapin. Nine-8 the score for Toronto. Lakehead. Jasmine Fox. I'll tell you, the whole arena brightens up after she hits it. Damon with a tough serve. Tie score now. 9-9. With that, it goes to 10-9 Toronto. So Lakehead making some great plays, but not able to string them together quite yet. Game very early. Lakehead with lots of time. They got to do it now on their home court. Back set to Corkaway. Nice persistence. A shoot set in the middle for Fox. And Fox is on the shoot set now. Getting some production from the middle is just what this Lakehead team needs. Diversify its attack between the right side hitting of Corkaway and the left side hitting of Damon. They can get that middle going with Fox and McLeod. They'll be doing well. Here's a back set to Corkaway. Into the hole in the middle, gets it, and believe gives Lakehead their first lead of the game, 11-10, here in the first set from the Thunderdome. Fox serve. It's going to be tight. Damon with the dig. Bump set to Reed with space. Nice placement on the tip. Sider. That free ball attack. Back set to Corkaway, and she drills it. That Toronto block not quite together. And Corkaway finding the hole. Ooh. Fox trying to serve tough. A little too zealous on that one. Go back to Toronto. Lakehead still with the lead. Tough set in the middle. In the middle now for Toronto. Damon, that's going to be tight. Good effort by Lakehead. Can't quite get it to go. Tough pass. Good set from Hudson. Corkaway scores. Net violation by the Varsity Blue blockers. In that sequence anyhow. Here's Corkaway's serve. In the middle. He's going to have to reach for it. Tough play by Corkaway. And Hudson in rhythm. Very well done. Showing some of her talents that we saw last year, but yet to see much of this year. Reed has to really reach for that one. It was wide out the antenna and hits a little too hard. Perhaps Sarah Hudson feeling more like her old self. I noticed she colored her hair back to blonde. I barely even recognized her. at the start of the year with brown hair, but she's back to her old self and setting like it as well on the court here in the Thunderdome. Lakehead with the lead, 14-13. Blocked. Good recovery in the middle. Here's Damon. Back to the corner, up at the net. It's going to be tight. Hill horse to Reed. Outside to Sider. Sider. Big hit. Reed. Back pass. Toronto with another free ball opportunity. Going back set this time. Fantastic beach dig from Hillhorst. Sider again. And another. Outside to Sider. Third time. Can't get this one to go. Long rally. Here's Sider again. Lakehead with a chance now. Here's Reed with single coverage. Dug up by Toronto. And that will mark the end of the rally. Quite possibly one of the longer ones we've seen this year. Great resilience by the Lakehead defense. Unable to seal the deal, but I think they might be able to get some energy off that sequence anyhow. 14-all the score. And 15-14 now Toronto. That reception error by Damon. Reed, hard off the block. Off the top of the net, dug up by Hillhorst and Damon. I believe both got a pancake dig on the play there, but not enough life in the ball for Reed to get under it. So serving for U of T, Shannon Russell. Shoot in the middle. Toronto digs it up. Sider, free ball. Nice attack. Damon in the middle from the back court. Dents dug up. Nice attack there from Jennifer Nielsen. So 17-14 the score. Chris Green looking to interrupt any notion of a U of T run. Lakehead could certainly use getting this first set point here instead of trailing behind. Shannon Rassall. Tough serve. It's gotten back. and over. Outside to Sider. Sider. And that dug up, but wisely played by Sider on the other side of the net. Lands out of bounds. Rasal. Great pass this time from Reed, I believe it was. Sider a little light on that one, and it's 18-15. Off the block. Great hustle by Vercane on that play, not able to complete it. 19-15 the score. Julia Bellumar with the serve. Outside, Damon. Blocked again to Damon. Finds the space on the left side of the block that time. 19-16. Lakehead trails. Back to service, McLeod. Had some success last time at the service line. That one looking a little long. Chris Green will call a second timeout. Lakehead needing a pass here. Sider serve passed by Hillhorst. Fox finds the middle, hole in the middle. Oh, and Damon with a tricky play on the second hit. Gets it to go. 20-17. Big play from Hudson there. Makes it 20-18. Hudson on her second serve. It's another pretty tough one, but it's passed up well. Hillhorst the dig. Outside to Damon. Off the net and up. Hillhorst will put this. Trying to get to the deep corner. Back set to Nielsen. Dug up by Corkaway. Again. Hillhorst puts it over. Nielsen again, going back to her. It's up by Vercane. Hillhorst will get this back in play with the help of Corkaway. Oh, and a misplay. Not sure what happened on that play. Miscommunication. Lakehead catches a break. It's 20-19, and that's going to be a timeout for U of T. So 20-19, Lakehead, a little 3-0 run. Looking to make a move here in the first set. Back set to Nielsen. That is off the block and out. Point Toronto. Back to serve, Sarah Chapin. 21-19, Toronto leads here in the first set from the Thunderdome. Back set to Damon. And that catches a piece of the block. Subbing in is Sarah Reed. So front row is Reed, Cork away, and Fox. Lakehead serve sails long. I believe makes that three or four this set. Back set to Cork away. In there. McLeod back into the game for Hillhorst. Nice pass. It's in the middle. Dug up. Gets it back to the other side. Outside. Off the block hard. And into the Lakehead bench. 23-21. Use a point here. Hillhorst, nice pass. Shoots that in the middle. Block is right there, but Hillhorst right there to recover for Lakehead. Off the Toronto block. It's up and back. Again to Nielsen. Didn't have her footwork quite right on that play, I believe. Looked like she had a one-foot takeoff. So here's Corkaway back to serve. 23-22 Toronto. And that will tie the game. Tough break for the Blues there. And Vanessa Masters being called quickly into the game by Coach Chris Green. And we're going to get a couple of subs on both sides here. Lakeheads for blocking purposes. Hudson in the front row. Going to want Masters there. In the middle. Dug up by Damon on the back row. Bump set to Reed. It's tight. Very close play. Sider outside has to reach for it. It is down on the Thunderwolf's side. 24-23. Hudson back in the game. Shen Rassal. Read the pass. Cork away in the back row. A little too umph. Drops the first set. Lakehead 23, U of T 25.
perfect person. I need
your insight. So here underway in the second set, Lakehead getting the first point. U of T. Taking the first set, of course, as well as that point. It's tied at one. Back to serve, Charlotte Sider. Ooh, and Borkaway wires one down the line. Here's Fox. Tip, not over the net, however. That'll give Lakehead its third point of the set. It's 3-1. Here in the second set. Good cross-court attack there. Alexandra Hudson. Back to serve, Sarah Chapin. In the middle. Frees up Borkaway for that attack. Again at the net. Reed's attack. Got a piece of it. Toronto's going to fire back here. McLeod with a stop there. Here's Alexandra Hudson. Damon tries to drop it down. Ball to carry on the second hit. Two Lakehead. Tough break for the Blues there. Oh, that second hit under more scrutiny than the others for carrying. And that is out. 4-3, Lakehead leads. Borkaway with the kill. 5-3 Lakehead. Reception error there. Another Lakehead point. I hear the voice of Breanne Hillhorst. A little bit of guidance for the Lakehead team. Good rallying cry there. See if it can continue to work for Lakehead. That one off the block and out. It'd be 6-4 now for Lakehead. Toronto to serve. And here's the other Hudson on the court, Alexandra Hudson. Free ball to Toronto. Dug up, pancake by Borkaway, beauty. Outside set to Sider. Puts it home. Lakehead really digging hard right now. Still need a few more plays to make it happen. Damon off the block. Quick in the middle, another block. Sider finds the corner. Vacant corner. That ties it up at 6 points apiece here in the second set from the Thunderdome. Tipped that time by Sarah Hudson. That one catches the line. 7-6. Tough serve. Good play by Damon. Not taking any risks. Up by Corkaway, but out of the reach of Hudson. And it'll go back to Alexandra Hudson to serve. Damon shot. Touch off the block. So that'll be a point for Lakehead. It's 8-7 now, Toronto. Damon uncorks one there. Ties it up at 8. She works so hard. Really big driving force behind this Lakehead team. Tough play. Toronto able to make it happen. Lakehead in transition. Tough play there. Reed with the dig out to Damon. Gonna have to work it. With the right finesse, finds the back corner. Taking a little something off at that time. We're going to get a substitution for Toronto. Number one. I think it would be Denise Wooding. However, I believe I just heard a teammate say Dennis Wooding. So I don't know if that's a nickname. Or what, but she is on the court now. She's likely going to receive this serve from Brittany McLeod. That serve is long. It's really a tough way to give up points. I think that was their Achilles heel in the first set. Such a close set. Anyhow, they're going to have to make do and try to find a way here in set number two. And Fox. Good job getting up on that one. And good job by Damon. Encouraging her to get up on that one. It was her ball, and she told her it was her ball all the way. And Fox reacting, making a call. And my goodness. That was a kill if I ever saw one. Charlotte Sider. Annual All-Star, I believe, in the OUA. And Corkaway. A little mustard on that one. Damon with the service error. Walking a hard road right now. 12-11. Lakehead still in the lead. Charlotte Sider to serve. Good pass in the middle. Shoot, set. But off the top of the net is the attack by Jack Fox. Good try there. Reed's attack. It's dug up. Toronto making a run. Sorry. 13-12 now. Back to Corkaway. Great block by Dennis Wooding. But Vanessa Corkaway with the second effort, getting right back up, which is really a tough thing to do in any sport when you're jumping a lot, is not so much how high your first jump is, but how high your second jump is. That. It's a nice dig by Fox, but just nobody there to put the play together. Toronto leading by one, 14-13 here in the second set. Toronto taking the first set, 25-23. Lakehead trying to even things up here in the second set. And they even the score at 14. Tough play. Toronto making the most of it, though. My. Salvaged what seemed like a bit of a busted play there. Lakehead blockers not getting the downward bounce they wanted off of that hit. Back set to McLeod. Outside. Dennis Wooding. On Reed. So 16-14 Toronto, identical score as set number one. Toronto with a two-point advantage at the break here. Lakehead needing to make some adjustments. See Mike Smith, assistant coach, giving Brittany McLeod some blocking tips. She's probably mentioning that attack that just skipped across the block and sharply crossed the court and out of bounds off the Lakehead block. Here's Jen Nielsen. Sneaky back set. Ooh, and that is a killer. Now, if there's anything I'm sure of with Chris Greener is that he wants his players to play balls. Don't take risks on these chancy ones that may be out, might not be out. And that'll prompt a timeout. Yeah. 18-14, so Toronto with two quick points out of the technical timeout. And now they do trail by four in this second set. So, Jen Nielsen. We'll see, trying to continue her run here from the service line. Hudson forced a tip back to the Lakehead side again. Hudson forced a tip, gets a nice placement on it this time. Jen Casey back to serve. Casey entering the game out of that timeout, I believe. Chris Green trying to switch things up a little bit. Casey offering a little more firepower on the attack. She is hidden right now from the serve. Vanessa Corkway in front of her. So Denise Wooding in the middle, outside to Damon. Has to tip it. Right there, Charlotte Sider, rather, with a nice attack. Toronto digging deep. Corkaway. Damon with single coverage. Finds a hole in the block and gets it down for a point. It's critical right now. Lakehead needs to get some stops. Nicole Verkane. Going to come in for Brittany McLeod to serve. Lakehead trailing by three. Outside to Sider. I believe a touch. Yes. And out. Shannon Rasal. Outside to Damon. Off the block. Dug up on the back line. Sider has to reach for it. Cutting it a little sharper across the court than she might like. And Sarah Hudson will go back to serve for Lakehead now, trailing by three. Fox. Right there on the job. Pushing it right down. 2-point lead for Toronto. Hudson serve. Sider blocked by Corkaway. Again. Off the hands of Corkaway and down on the LU side this time. 21-18. Julia Bellumau. Going line. Net violation on Toronto. Damon serve. In the middle. And this time Lakehead whistled for the net violation, although that was likely going to be a point regardless. So Hillhorse back on. Passes it. Back set. Wow. Just on the right side of the net that time, or rather the Toronto side of the net as it falls off the block. 22-20 the score. Fox the serve. And Corkaway with a big solo block. Back set now. It's tight. Back on the Toronto side. I think everybody thought that was on the Toronto side, although it falls on the Lakehead side. That's going to prompt a substitution for Toronto. And Lakehead's going to take a timeout. 23-22. So really sort of the swing point there. Lakehead with the opportunity to make it 22 all, instead trails 23-21. Bit of a breakdown in communication, it might seem. So they're getting it together now in the timeout, going to see if they can get their play figured out for this next serve reception. Shannon Rasal for Toronto, a fifth-year veteran from Calgary, Alberta. She's pumped up, wanting to will her team to victory here on the road. Lakehead looking to make some noise. Good attack by Corkaway. Nice defense by Toronto. Going to be tight at the net again. It's 24-21. Toronto getting the point there. Sarah Chapin, set point, Toronto. In the middle, McLeod. Can't get the action on that they were looking for. Lakehead drops the second set, 25-21. Sorry, folks. Catch you up on the action. It's a 5-all here in the third set. Just having a little discussion with one of Lakehead's former staffers, just discussing some strategy and some of the technical side of those first two sets. Trying to expand my knowledge of the game here. Stephanie Chartrand that time hammering it in the middle. So 6-all, Toronto to serve. Denise Wooding. Outside to Damon. Single coverage that time. Toronto recovers. Hillhorst with the dig. Back to Toronto now. Jen Nielsen finding some space on the outside of the block. 7-6 Toronto. Corkaway getting that one to score. Ties it up at 7. Fox back into the game. Here's Chartrand. Outside to Sider. Jasmine Fox, the big block. That's the kind of stops they need. Eight, seven now. Top serve from Chartrand, sneaking it over the net. Make that a 9-7 lead. Gonna be a timeout on U of T now. So a little switch up in the lineup this time around. Chartrand in for McLeod, I believe, as well as Jen Casey getting a look here in the third set. Tough play, going to be Damon, big attack. Sider gets that one to go just inches from the curtain at the top of the roof. Sider's attack this time is out. 10-7 now for Lakehead. Getting a bit of energy now. Crowd getting into it. Top serve again from Chartrand. Very deceptive serves. Short and coming in on a diagonal. Let's see what she's got this time. This one, a little more easy to field. Lakehead with an opportunity. Damon. Double teamed on the block. That'll end up for a point for Toronto. 4-0 run for Lakehead has ended. And it's 11-8 Toronto serving Shannon Rasal. Outside to Damon off the block and out of bounds. 4-point lead. Lakehead could certainly use some quick points here, see if they can get a quick win, not expend so much energy trying to fight their way back into this game. Net violation on the Lakehead blockers. 12-9 now the score. Number 13, Madeline Mandrick serving for Toronto. Damon, meanwhile, putting a stamp on this game once again. 13-9, Damon back to serve. Dug up by Hillhorse. Corkaway, the tip. Great timing for that. Not a desperation tip, just switching it up, keeping the defense on their toes, getting the point. 14-9 now. Outside to Casey. Oh, quick attack. Something seemed a little out of sync on her windup. Lakehead needing to keep their focus. 4-point lead now. Here's Sider. That one off the tape and down. So a 5-point advantage now for Lakehead. Big block by Stephanie Chartrand. 16-10 now. So 16-10. Chris Green with some coaching for Casey. Probably just telling her to stay confident. Second year player Casey. Got some burn last year, but playing a bit, being asked to play a bit bigger role this year. And has to remain confident. I mean, with a game like volleyball, it's the slightest doubt can result in a blink of an eye breakdown, and the play will be over before you know it. And Casey really playing an important role, being able to score points from the outside. You give some space for Vanessa Corkway on the other side to draw some of the attention away from her. Lakehead in the driver's seat here, but still needing some solid serving and continue digging. Get this third set under their belt and see if they work on fighting their way back into this game. Fox. Top serve off the arms of Denise Wooding. 17-10 now. Same placement on the serve, fielded this time by number two, the libero. Tough play on Lakehead side. 17-11 now. Sarah Chapin back to serve for Toronto. Mm-hmm. Hillers off the block. That's what she brings to the table, folks. Jen Casey with a very powerful swing, and she can get a hold of it. Corkaway, 18-11. Lakehead needing to close out this third set. Here's Casey again. Free ball to Lakehead. Needs some help on that one. Probably not the way they would have liked it. Dug up. Casey up. Hillhorse to Damon. Back row attack. Up at the net. Can't get it dug up. The Varsity Blues. It'll be another Lakehead point and a Toronto timeout. Lakehead leading 19-11. So, I believe Vanessa Master is going to come in the game for blocking purposes for Sarah Hudson. Lakehead trying to put their foot on the gas pedal right here. Outside set to Wooding. That one off the arms of Masters. Coming in cold off the bench. Maybe wasn't ready for that one. We'll have to get on this learning curve here. Tough go for Vanessa Masters. Casey the pass. Oh, and a tough set from Hudson. 19-14 now. Jen Nielsen back to serve for Toronto. Made a three-point run, make that four. But seeming to have lost some of the command they had previously had. So they'll line up. Certainly could use a quick point here. Damon with the pass. Step around attack, not there, but was there touch? Yes, yes. Touch on the block called. So a break for Lakehead, 20-15. I notice that so much in volleyball, the how good a team can be at playing that there was no block when trying to convince the referees otherwise. But good job by the refs. Both of them saw it. Big dig by Corkaway. Back to Damon. That one was off the block. 21-15. Toronto blocking just a little bit late. Here's Nicole Verkane. Lakehead leading 21-15. Chris Green giving the mark to go after. Great pass by Verkane, sneaking over the net. Not sure who gets credit for that one. If Hudson got a little touch to force that one. 22-15, though. Nicole Verkane with the serve. Looking to close this one out. In the middle. Dug up by Damon. Damon will put it over. Close at the net. Hill horse to dig. Damon puts it over again. Falls down on the Toronto side off the block. 23-15. Lakehead with life here in this third set. Outside to Wooding. Had one dig, but not the follow-up as Denise Wooding, who's had a fairly good night so far at the net hitting, switches it up with the tip. Lakehead almost recovered, but not quite. Shows he's back to serve now is Wooding. The set is up to Damon. Cross court. No touch. And just about 6 inches wide. Wooding. Serve. Hudson with a tricky back set tip. 24-17. Chartrand serve. One of their better servers. Outside to Sider. Big kill there from Charlotte Sider. Lakehead blocking will likely have to stop her. Although with a point scored here and a good pass, Lakehead can close out this third set. Verkane, beautiful pass out to Damon. Lots of space, puts it away. 25-18 is your score for Lakehead here in the third set, and we got a game, everybody. We do thank you for tuning in, of course, SSNCanada.ca, where you can catch the game today, of course, and tomorrow. In the booth here with my man, Andrew Kirion. Kirion, what'd you think about that third set?
Girls really came out and got it done, really. That's all it's coming down to right now. Dug in and put it together.
Seemed like those sort of mental mistakes from the first two sets not as prevalent. I ask you only because of your familiarity with the game of volleyball. You're a big fan. And, you know, everyone here in the Thunderdome, it's all one big family here. Should mention Andrew Kirion, of course, an assistant on the men's team. Not the result we wanted last night on either the men's or women's. Tough loss for the women in OT. Guys, sort of got run off the court against Queens. What was the feeling in the locker room?
Well, obviously after a loss like that, you know, we're pretty disappointed in our performance. We got a veteran team, and especially in our home opener, our court, this atmosphere, we'd like to come out a lot stronger than that. That being said, you got to give some credit to Queens. They played a phenomenal game. We had a really solid film and practice session today, kind of identified some areas that we know we need to improve on, address some team things. So hopefully it was a good learning experience, and the last one we'll have to take of that nature this year.
Sounds good. I don't know what happened in our little Subway sandwich making contest there, but
a little bit of a slip-up.
A little fiasco. Who's the winner? There's vegetables and cheese and meat everywhere. Getting hungry.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
All right, so a little fun and games here happening in the Thunderdome. Hopefully lighten up the mood and let these girls resume their focus that they showed in that third set. Good fight in the girls this time around. Had a bit of a personnel switch up with Chartrand and Casey coming in there. Did some pretty good work. We'll see how they do in just a few minutes. Here from the Thunderdome on SSNCanada.ca. So here we are in the fourth set, 3-3 the score. Charlotte Sider serving for UT. Nice attack, better dig. Jory Damon finishing off the play with a point for the home side. 4-3 the score. Casey serve. Drops in. Tough dig. Here's Damon. Has to play it. I'm not sure. It was off Damon's hand and out. Four four now. Dennis Wooding. Outside, Damon. Off Wooding's arms. 5-4. Lakehead leads. Stephanie Chartrand now. Had some success with her serves in the last set. Fox getting to that one. Well done. Outside line, dug up. Well done by Corkaway. Damon. Not bad placement on that one. Wooding puts it over to Damon with the attack. This one off the block and out. Very good awareness by Corkaway. Not playing that ball and letting it fly out of bounds. 6-4 the score here in the fourth set. Lakehead down 2-1. Outside, off the top of the block, dug up, outside to Damon, going to get another swing at it. Quick in the middle. Nice play by Damon. Over by Fox. Step around attack. No, going in the middle. Tough play. And Corkaway on that play. Holding back, almost getting a foot on it, actually. 6-5, Lakehead leads. Shannon Rassall. Serving here. Tough reception there from Casey. Tough rotation. Hillhorst looking to cover Casey as best she can, as is Damon, for the service reception. To Casey again. Tough pass. Blocking error. A net violation by Toronto. Lakehead catches a break. 7-6. Dig by Hillhorst. Here comes Corkaway on the attack. Setter had to play that one. Bit of a busted play. Lakehead will get another shot out here with Damon on the outside. Splits the block. Puts it right down for a big rally win there. Lakehead asserting themselves here. Back set, dug up by Hudson. Tight at the net. Tight play. That one is point Toronto. Fox's attack, easily dug up. Sider. Hillhorst now, Damon tight, off the block. Toronto recovers, but not all the way. Good effort, though. Big serve from Damon. Timeout. U of T, Lakehead leading 10-7. So out of that timeout, Toronto putting a couple of points together, and I'm also joined by Chris McLennan here in the booth, going to give us a little extra insight on some of the action on the court. Yeah! Big attack from Casey that time, Chris, but the block all over it. Big dig in the back from Corkaway. Casey's attack is dug up on the other side. Here's Wooding. Hudson to the outside. Casey off the block. Dug up. Wooding again going cross and out. Just a few inches.
Yeah, it was a close ball. That was some excellent transition ball. Played by both sides there. Some great defense. Able to transition with some solid left side attacks. And Thunder Rolls were able to come up with the point on that one.
Hudson out to Casey. Gets the point.
This is a good sign for the Thunderwolves here, starting to heat up in the fourth set. Looking to push back, tie this up at two sets apiece. Jennifer Casey out there on the left side is really starting to find her groove.
So Lakehead certainly sort of in control right now, 16-10. They had a little bit of a change up out of that last time when they were up 16-10, 16-11. Coach Green putting in Masters for the blocking purposes. I think trying to put the pedal to the metal at that point. Would that be correct in assumption on that substitution?
Absolutely. I mean, at that point in the game, they're looking to, you know, when you lose it 3, 4, 5 points in a row, as the opposing team, you're going to be looking to put the ball in the hands of your best attacker. For U of T, it's going to be number 3, Charlotte Sider. And so they're looking to, you know, in that particular rotation, I believe they put Vanessa up in the front row to block as Charlotte was hitting out of the left side in that particular serve receive.
A tough assignment, though, to be called in off the bench and just say, block like hell this point.
You know what? You're absolutely right. I mean, it's on every team you have your position players, you have your role players. And, you know, sometimes you need to come off the bench and do the job that you are designated to do.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, that's an important piece to every team is the ability to come off the bench and fill a gap, fill a role, and be successful to help your team get to 25 first.
Indeed. Toronto coming back with a score on that exchange. Here's Casey. No touch. Going to be point Toronto, so 2 points to Toronto after the technical timeout. 16-12 here in the fourth set. Sider serve a little tricky. Corkaway on the attack. Nice dig in the back row. Wooding dug up by Corkaway. And Casey coming up with some plays today.
Yeah, I mean, she's, as we were talking about just a minute ago there, having a specific role on each team, role players, position players, whatever it may be. She has done a formidable job tonight just coming off the bench and filling in for Sarah Reed. And, you know, keeping the ball alive on the outside and powering through a couple of double blocks when she's seen 4 big sticks up there. So she's done an excellent job tonight coming off the bench.
In the middle for Toronto, Shannon Russell, I believe, or Russell. Clear leader for Toronto, doing a great job. Vocal leader at the net.
Yeah, you can see, you know, as her ability to watch the play and read the play and, you know, in transition, come off the net from a block into an offensive position where she's off the net and ready to go right away again. That's an important thing to have your middles to... You know, if you want to use the middles as an option or put the ball out to the left side, you have to be able to have your middles come on out and be an option in the front row every time.
Huge kill by Damon after a long rally. She really placed it well right inside a 1.5-foot box probably in that far corner.
You know, she's also another player that in this third and fourth set has really started to shine a little bit tonight after a fantastic outing last weekend against Windsor. Putting the ball in her hands a little bit more now and getting a little bit of a one-on-one option out on the left side as opposed to, you know, lots of double blocks. The Thunderwolves are doing a good job of putting the ball in her hands for sure.
So here's Russell. Hillhorse, the pass, Corkaway the attack, and it's long. We noticed a bit of that tonight. Toronto backing off on the backcourt attack from Vanessa Corkaway and preferring to play, you know, all diggers rather than no blockers on that. Is that probably just to eliminate any chance of a tip out of bounds, I guess?
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple of different reasons why you might want to do something like that, where you might want to not worry about a blocker. If you peel everybody off the net, you know that a C-ball attack is going to be hit to a deeper part of the court.
Yeah.
So if you already have all of your defenders off the net, back from the 3-meter line, ready to play a ball in the deeper part of the court, then you stand a better chance of digging it up. And I mean,
absolutely.
there's always a 50-50 chance of. You know, it goes in the net, it goes in the court. So
here is Shannon Russell. Big attack. Jory Damon, I think the DJ got an assist on that play.
Yeah, he was enjoying the tunes a little bit too long there. But at this point in the game, that's exactly what the Thunderwolves need to do. They need to continue putting the ball in the hands of their hot hitters. And here we go for Jory again.
Ooh. Tight, tight play there. Linesman with a much better view on it than myself at this angle. So
that was, you know, that was a fantastic job by Jory to come off the net and put herself in a position where she could actually get a legitimate attack instead of a roll shot or a tip.
Yep. And I think
I think the referee may have interpreted the setter, who is in the back row right now, Sarah Hudson, might have said she played the ball over the plane of the net there, which...
And I thought it was off Fox's hand.
Well, Sarah, the number 10 in the back row, the setter, she's not allowed to play the ball over the plane of the net there. And it appeared from here that it looked like a good set, good force in the middle, but referee had a different idea.
Toronto on the attack now. Back set from Hillhorst to Corkaway. You got to love it when those types of plays go down. 20-17 Lakehead now. And Damon back to serve. On the attack, and that... With that type of situation, whereas Toronto was peeling off that sort of back row attack, that time our blockers working a bit against us. Hudson. Tough play.
You know, here's an opportunity for the Lady Thunderbolts after this time out here to regroup. They're still a long ways before this match is over. They need to sort of get checked back into this game and, you know, control, because it all starts with one pass, because you know you're gonna get a serve, you know you gotta pass the ball, and sometimes it's as simple as that. You know, it sounds very, very simple, but that's exactly what it is. Girls have to go out here after the timeout and focus on this next ball. Forget about the last couple and continue to push all the way to 25 in this fourth set.
Well, why not? Let's get a fifth set going here. I want to see this game pushed to the limit, because Lakehead... The hardcore volleyball fans are out tonight, and they could certainly use something to talk about. Back set now to Sider. Cross-court attack. Ooh. Fox called on the net. Tough break there at such a critical point in the match.
You know, it was a well-executed play. Jasmine's getting up there, doing her job, being aggressive on the block, and just a little bit too much there.
And that will be a point. I don't foresee any player leaping into the fourth row of the stands, although it's come close.
That would be a pretty good effort to see.
So Fox back to serve. Now with the lead, 21-20 Lakehead, fourth set. Big attack there. Hudson, great dig. Sider again. Going cross court. Yikes.
At this point in the match, U of T is going to be going back to their number one gun right now, Charlotte Sider, number three, who's moved to the right side. Last three sets have all gone to her. That's what they're going to continue to do until she's back in the back row here. Want to utilize her power up in the front row before she sits in the back for probably the duration of this set.
21-all. Sarah Chapin, serve. Floater. Back set to Corkaway, sharp angle. Quick set in the middle, dug up by Corkaway. Back set to Casey, she tips. Sider, one against two. And that is off the dig and out of play. 22-21 now. Toronto taking its first lead in some time this set.
Thunderwolves got away with one right off the bat there. The libero's not allowed to set the ball with her hands in front of the attack line and have it set up for an attack, but the referees must have missed that one.
Dug up by Hudson. Back set to Sider. Blocked. Casey. Getting a little redemption on that play. 22 all.
My guess is this ball is going to go to Charlotte on the right side here.
Quick in the middle.
Nope.
And Shannon Rasal in the middle with that point. Lakehead with their backs against the wall, 23-22. Have to get this set to force a fifth. We may have a substitution upcoming from Lakehead. Here's Sider serve to Casey. Any touch? No. Sharply hit there. Brittany McLeod enters the game. 24-22, Lakehead trails. Outside, Casey. Again. Finds the spot.
Keep forcing it. Sooner or later, it's going to come through for you.
24-23. Lakehead really needing a point here, absolutely. Outside. Dug up by Toronto. Wooding.
No touch. I think the Thunderwolves got cheated a little bit on that last point of the match there. The last attack by U of T on the left side there did not appear to touch any hands on the block, but that's unfortunate. They fought hard tonight.
Hard way to lose. Last set, 25-23.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. The Thunderwolves were able to come back in that third and fourth set and play strong based on the fact that they were able to, you know, identify what they needed to do offensively, and that was to spread the ball, spread the block, and get some one-on-ones on the outside there. Just came up a little too short.
So, final score, U of T 3, Lakehead 1. Set scores, U of T winning 25-23, 25-21, 18-25. And 25-23. Lakehead has to turn around and come back tomorrow against a tough Ryerson team. It's 5-1 right now, depending on some outcomes from earlier today. But this will be the final home game for Lakehead before Christmas. What can we expect tomorrow from the Thunderwolves, maybe, and from the Ryerson side? Any insights there, Chris?
Well, if I'm a betting man, having the pleasure of knowing Chris Green and a bunch of the athletes on this team, they're going to come back. They're going after this match. They're going to go back to work. You know, being the professionals that they are, they'll take the time to, you know, study film, come up with a game plan, and concentrate from now until tomorrow at 2 p.m. Eastern, and come out and execute the game plan as best to the best of their ability. I mean. That Ryerson team, they pose an interesting threat, as they don't run a regular offensive system with, you know, running middle attacks right out of the middle. It's a bit of an interesting, different scheme that they run that we'll have the pleasure of seeing all tomorrow.
And you can join us at 2 p.m. Eastern here from Thunderdome on ssncanada.ca for the Lakehead Thunderwolves versus Ryerson Rams, as Lakehead look to try to get a home victory before the Christmas break tomorrow. We hope you'll join us then for Chris McLennan and Hillary McDowell up in the booth. My name's Hugh Mullally. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you tomorrow.